Assalamu alaikum. My name is Kainat Raza Khan and my group members are Salwa Ali and Talat Batul. Our FIP title is Design and Development of Prototype for Surgical Robot. In contrast to open surgery, minimal invasive surgery is an innovative surgical technique that allows the surgeon to limit the size and number of incisions that they need to make. One of the development states of MIS is robot-assisted surgery, in which a surgeon makes small incisions to guide the endoscope and robotic tools into the body. From there, the surgeon controls the surgery while sitting at a nearby computer console. In contrast to traditional surgery, robotic surgeries have improved outcomes, such as quicker recovery, decreased post-operative pain, and less scars. Due to the rapid progress and potential benefits of robotic system over the conventional surgical techniques, more and more people are opting for robot-assisted surgical procedures, and the demand is increasing day by day. A study was conducted using the clinical registry data from 73 hospitals in Michigan, USA for a period of January 2012 till June 2018. This study concluded that the use of robotic surgery for all general surgery procedures have increased dramatically from 1.8% to 15.1% over the years, in contrast to open and laparoscopic surgery. Recent work also suggests that United States now performs more robotic surgeries than any other country in the world. In contrast, robotic surgery in Pakistan was initiated by the installation of first Da Vinci surgical system at the Sindh government Qatar Hospital Karachi in 2011, followed by a second system with more advanced feature in Civil Hospital Karachi in 2013. However, robotic surgeries are still not being widely used here. Moreover, a Pakistan-based study calculated a cost of around Rs 300 million along with 10% of annual maintenance contract cost for these robotic platforms, indicating the reason behind its hindrance. In developing countries such as Pakistan, despite of the potential benefits, major hindrance to the availability of robotic surgery is due to its high cost along with the recurring cost of disposable and service contracts.
So for that reason, there is a need to develop innovative solutions which can help surgeons to achieve the best possible results with a reduced cost and improved efficiency. Therefore, the focus of this project was to design and develop a prototype for a surgical robot that might aid in the performance of any surgical task.
So here's the objectives of our project. The first one was to select a surgical instrument that would be capable of performing a surgical task. The second one was sensing and actuation method. The third one was to design a control architecture for the system with suitable controller and input components. The fourth one was software simulation, and the fifth one was hardware implementation.
These are the modified aims and objectives. Although the hardware implementation was not included in our modified objectives, but we made every effort to implement it. In the end, we able to develop one robotic arm with 5 TOFs that could efficiently perform the modified task of grasping the surgical tools like suturing needles or blade. We have read many research papers to make a pathway of our project. By examining more than 50 research papers, it developed more knowledge. Then we extracted some points from research papers for our project. So in this table, an overview is provided that describes briefly about the specification of some of the surgical robots from 1985 till today, and also how these specifications evolved with time. So here's the methodology of our project. Firstly, we had to choose a surgical task performed by our robotic arm. Then we choose the gripper. Then we design the mechanical structure of robotic manipulators according to the degree of freedom which we required. Then the software simulation was selected. Then we selected the motors and input device to perform the desired task. Then we designed and developed the control system architecture using motors and motor drivers. And at the end, we get the final prototype. So here's the proposed block diagram of our project. The design of the system consists of two main parts, main console and robotic manipulators. Main console comprises of input device and a display screen with a camera. And robotic manipulators include robotic arms equipped with surgical instruments and a main controller that controls the servo motors. So this one is modified block diagram, in which it has only one robotic arm instead of two robotic arms, because due to pandemic COVID-19, we couldn't achieve our expected results. in order to practice suturing, we have used drumsticks. Chicken meat seems to be a suitable tool for learning suturing on. Suturing on chicken meat was performed in order to identify the following points. The number one is the required motion time. The second one is number of DOFs. And the third one is the angle for the insertion of sutures. So here's the five number of motion that we have identified after the practicing suture on chicken piece. The number one is opening and closing of the gripper. The number two is tilting forward and backward along y-axis. Number three is moving forward and backward on y-axis. Number four is tilting side to side on x-axis. And the last one is turning left and right on z-axis. While selecting the gripper, we needed to focus on these features. It must be lightweight. It should be capable of holding thin and small instruments. It must have rigid shape and double action jaws. We had two options, 3D printing and laparoscopic instrument. We had not selected the 3D printing gripper because it wasn't feasible, it's easily breakable, and we can't fabricate the small size gripper by 3D printer. So the laparoscopic grasper was selected as a suitable end effector according to the task selected for the robot, as it could easily grasp the surgical tools like suturing needle or blades. It is made of a durable material and is flexible in every size.
Now moving to our next point, that is software simulation. The software that we used to draw the 3D model of our prototype was SolidWorks. This software was chosen because it is possible to sketch the design, experiments with features and dimensions, and produce a three-dimensional model. Our 3D model simulation is given in this video. Simulation of control circuit. So for the simulation of control circuit, we used Proteus. This figure illustrates the control circuit design by integrating an Arduino UNO with 5 servo motors as required by the mechanical design. Joystick module couldn't be implemented in Proteus, so we used potentiometer as an input to actuate the servo motors. Prototype design. Here is the prototype of surgical robot that was designed by starting from the end effector to the base of the robot, as can be seen in this picture. The overall design uses arm links, base and actuators. The prototype has 5 degrees of freedoms, including the grippers. Development of prototype. Laparoscopic grasper assembly. Laparoscopic grasper mechanism is designed for the placement of gripper and motors. Motor number 1 is responsible for opening and closing of the gripper. That was achieved by pushing the shaft of the gripper forward and backward respectively, while motor number 2 is rotating the gripper. Opening and closing of the gripper was accomplished by rotational to linear conversion method by using a sliding mechanism equipped with rods and spring. The push of the motor number 2 will open and close the jaw of the gripper. Wrist mechanism. The wrist mechanism is similar to the wrist of the human arm. It consists of a cylindrical joint and wrist motor. The design joint connects the end effector with the rest of the manipulator links through motor, and this joint will allow the movement of the end effector along z-axis. Elbow mechanism. Elbow mechanism consists of parallel placed two links connected to a dual shaft motor at proximal end and held together distally by the wrist motor responsible for the movement of the end effector. And this mechanism is responsible for moving forward and backward along x-axis. Shoulder mechanism. The shoulder mechanism consists of a cylindrical rod, paired spur gear, ball bearing and shoulder motor, as can be seen in this picture. The cylindrical rod one end is connected to the U-shaped bracket attached with the wrist motor, whereas the other end is coupled with the gear and inserted in the ball bearing of the base. The motor is coupled with the cylindrical rod using a spur gear with a ratio of 1:3. The purpose of the ball bearing is to reduce rotational friction and support radial and axial loads, whereas the gear of 1:3 is reducing the speed and increasing the torque of the motor. This type of assembly will be beneficial for bearing the overall weight of the robotic arm. So the challenges that we faced during the development of our project. Firstly, we had to find a suitable end effector that could perform the desired surgical task. Our goal was to use a laparoscopic grasper in place of the end effector, as it could easily grasp surgical tools like suturing needles. However, the challenge was to find a grasper without its handle, so that it could be integrated with the manipulators. The next challenge was finding a motor. So motor with a higher torque rating would have been more suitable for the design. Nevertheless, the servo motors used in the prototype were of the maximum torque rating that could be found easily in Pakistan. Control system design. Controller. We selected Arduino as a controller for our project because it is easily programmable and it supports various facilities of communication with other devices and microcontrollers. Input. Our main idea was to use a wireless joystick, but because of the lockdown we couldn't order it. Hence, we used an Arduino compatible joystick, KY023 joystick module, and this was used to send input commands to the controller of the prototype, which results in the actuation of the servo motors. Motors. We selected our motors by looking at the specifications mentioned in the datasheet, along with other attributes like weight of our robotic arm, and also the motors which were easily available in Pakistan. So these are the motors with their specifications that we chose. Control architecture. The complete control circuit schematic is shown in this figure. A 6-volt DC power is provided to the PCA9685 servo driver through an ATX power supply. After stepping down from a 10 ampere DC to DC adjustable buck regulator or step down module. Joystick module along with the push button provides necessary input to the controlling unit, that is Arduino UNO, which then drives the servo motors according to the set conditions in the program.
The system flow here depicts the control of motors in response to the joystick input. If the condition when joystick position becomes greater than 800 gets true, there is a check for another condition. This condition gets true if servo motor position is less than its maximum PWM value, which results in the increment of servo motor position. Whereas, if the condition when joystick position is less than 300 gets true, it checks the condition applied for servo motor position. If the servo motor position is greater than the minimum PWM value, this condition gets true, resulting in the decrement of the motors. Similarly, at any instant, if the joystick switch is pressed, all the servo motors recenter their position to the set initial value. Initially, our objective was to fabricate two robotic arms that will perform the task of suturing, but due to lockdown imposed in response to pandemic COVID-19, it was changed. In the end, we were able to develop only one robotic arm equipped with a laparoscopic grasper. Following tables show the specification of our robot. Some of the technical specifications are: motion range is described here for each of the motors. The base motor can move the whole robot for a range of 10 degrees to 170 degrees. For a distance of 30 centimeter, the robot could successfully track the exact position. Distance and time was calculated for a couple of trials, which on average yields a speed of 0.0271 meter per second for the robot. Although due to pandemic COVID-19, we had to change our objectives, however, we were able to fabricate a surgical robot that could have 5 DOFs and could easily grasp surgical tools like suturing needles or blade. Following are our attained complex engineering problem attributes. These are the references cited in our presentation. That's all from our side. Thank you.